anyone who's played Grand Theft Auto knows, we do things in the video world that we wouldn't do face to face. It's like a video game, is what one young pilot described to me.
The Air Force's Predator system, its unmanned reconnaissance and strike plane, hunts enemies covertly from the sky, attacks on commands received by satellite, collects reconnaissance for ground troops through remote sensing, and removes enemy leadership with precise geographic target information.
The U.S. military calls the deaths of children in Pakistan's border area regrettable.
Since 2006, we've killed 14 senior al-Qaeda leaders using drone strikes. In the same time period, we've killed 700 Pakistani civilians in the same area. The drone strikes are highly unpopular. They are deeply aggravating to the population.
The airplanes are flying. They're flying long, they're flying hard, and they are making a big impact.
It's civilians who pay the highest cost. The attacks have killed around 700 to date.
Clearly, when you have a drone strike that kills a wedding party of 90 people, when you're really after one person, maybe even you didn't get that person, this contributes to the problem.
But no one thinks a Hellfire missile dropped from a remote control plane killing people is a joke, especially not for the 1 in 3 estimated to be civilians caught in the crossfire of drone strikes in Pakistan, for example.
What's no laughing matter are the numbers. Analysts believe between 900 and 1,400 people have been killed by drone attacks in Pakistan since 2004. Hundreds of those deaths have occurred this year, and hundreds are believed to be civilians.
And as Washington expands its drone strikes in Pakistan, the number of civilians killed in the attacks keeps rising, and hundreds of people have died since 2004. And critics say the program only helps fuel the conflict, creating new militants rather than eliminating them.
General McChrystal is doing everything humanly possible to avoid civilian casualties.
But the Wall Street Journal today revealed a cyber glitch with the Predators the Air Force runs in Iraq and Afghanistan. Insurgents in both countries have been able to intercept and monitor video feeds from the drones using cheap $26 software from the internet called SkyGrabber. Downloaded drone images have been found on captured laptop computers. Officials say while the militants were able to see the output of the Predators' cameras, they were not able to control the drones themselves. Transmitters on drones are being upgraded and encrypted to guard against hackers. Recently, the Air Force Chief of Staff showed Lara Logan a new handheld mobile receiver the troops will have to use to monitor the coded feed.
Oh, they're trying to get away. 94.
Flash 36.
Coming, the drums are drumming. If you know one, say a prayer. There's mothers crying and fathers sighing. War is in the air. Trains are filling up with boys. We've left behind their favorite toys. They're going.
The closest guys that I've ever had as friends are all dead.
Jonathan Grant, First Platoon Lima Company.
We lost a lot of guys, a lot of great guys.
What you're looking at is the image from the Predator's infrared camera as the pilots watch a Chinook helicopter offloading troops. This is happening in the dead of night, so on the ground it's pitch black. The Predator crew in Nevada was tasked to watch over the soldiers as they got some rest, pulling guard duty from half a world away. The crew spend hours studying suspected insurgents. They've just seen these men ambush U.S. troops. The pilot can take them out and still make it home in time for dinner. General Norton Schwartz is the chief of staff of the Air Force, its top military officer.
As a system, do you see anything that has done more damage to Al-Qaeda?
This is probably at the head of the line. It has become central to the way we operate.
Cameras mounted on the unmanned planes. It's what the soldiers on the ground call their eyes in the sky. Soldiers on the ground have come to depend on it.
I've heard the guys say, you know, they don't want to step out the door without eyes in the sky.
Sure. I have a brother who's in Army Special Forces. And honestly, I wouldn't want him stepping out the door without this thing over top of him either.
Lieutenant Colonel Chris Goff flew F-16 combat missions over Kosovo. Now he flies combat missions over Afghanistan by remote control.
Do you think that distance makes it, it's kind of like a video game and not like real life?
No, not at all. Because you know that there's no reset button. When you let a missile go and it's flying over the head of friendly forces and it's flying toward the enemy to kill somebody or to break something, you know that that's real life and there's no take back there.
He said, son, have you seen the world? Well, what would you say if I said that you could just carry this gun? You'll even get paid. I said, that sounds pretty good. Black leather boots, spit shine so bright. They cut off my hair, but it looks alright. We marched and we sang, we all became friends as we learned how to fight. A hero of war, yeah, that's what I'll be. And when I come home, they'll be damn proud of me. I'll carry this flag to the grave if I must, 'cause it's a flag that